morning.
Good morning.
We have video. I'm over there chatting away, going, corn cup gonna start any second. I see my wife's.
He wasn't listening to
the pastor. Well, that's fiddling with remote controls. Give a man a remote control, we can be entertained for hours and days, right, guys? It's good to be with everybody. It's good to have Jim and Belita back. Can we give them a round? Wait, don't clap for Jim. He hates that. Clap for Belita. We love you, Jim. We just missed you guys.
Thank you.
That's all I'm
saying. We have a speaker malfunctioning. Which is mostly distracting us more than it is to you guys. Sorry about that. No, that's true.
Hallelujah!
am so grateful that my stains have been washed away. Amen? Man, we heard such a great testimony last week from my brother Rick, did we not? It takes so much guts to bring your testimony here. God is so good to us. He's always been faithful to us to forgive our sins and to repent. But I always believe that God never lowered the bar by forgiving our sins and requiring a sacrifice of Jesus Christ. He maintained that bar at a bar of perfection that He required. And the only thing that would pay for our sins and our lack of perfection would be a perfect sacrifice in Jesus Christ. And so He did. He paid the ultimate price for us, because being perfect Himself, He was the only one who could. And He never, in other words, He never thought less of us. He never cheapened His love for us. And it always just hits me so hard when I think about it, about how much He really loves us. I know when like my kids mess up, sometimes I lower the bar, you know, to make it easier for them. But God's amazing in that. He's not codependent. He doesn't support bad habits. He just really wants us to be near Him. And I'm grateful for that, aren't you guys?
See.
feel like somebody might have a prophetic word for this church body. I hope it's time now for that. If you feel the Lord speaking on your heart, speak loud.
Such a good word, and we're not qualified to change ourselves. And yet we try so hard on our own strength, our own goals, our own plans, even without considering God a lot of times, don't we? Like, okay, it's 2017, this is what's happening in my life, this is what I'm going to do. And how long do those last? Sometimes they don't last very long. Our time is better spent before God, on our faces, surrendering to Him, asking Him what it is He wants in our lives, and to empower us to do those things. He is the one who gives us His strength. He's the one who gives us His power. I'm so glad, I don't know about you, I'm so glad it's not in my strength, aren't you? We are not very strong. We like to kind of rev it up and think that we can do amazing things, and we can't sustain it for maybe a short amount of time. But praise God, we're not alone, and praise God, we've got His strength inside of us. So I just encourage you to be empowered by Him. What that looks like is getting alone with Him and seeking Him, letting His word fill your mind and transform you, letting His presence fill you as you go through the day to share God's love. Just even your smallest actions with other people around you. God, empower us all this morning. Empower us all this week. Empower our lives. Let us seek you and take time before you to tap into your strength, to tap into your power, to tap into your hope, to tap into your peace, your joy, and your love, and your light in your life.
Savior, I come, quiet my soul, remember Redemption's hill, when your blood was spilled for my
To you, Lord, allow you to make the changes in us. We are not qualified to change ourselves, and we are terrible at it. God, you are wonderful, you are awesome and strong, but more than that, even you're loving and caring for us. The changes you want to make are not changes that are bad for us. They're changes that will help us and grow us and make us better people, make us more loving to each other. Lord, I just pray that that is all of our prayer today, Lord,
yes,
just
Lord.
To cleanse our minds and our hearts of ourselves, to surrender to you, Lord, this morning. We do. We surrender to you, and it brings such joy, and we are joyful daughters and sons in your presence this morning, and grateful, so grateful for all you give to us, all you bring to us, and the potential, the possibilities, and the hope for our future that you have for us. Thank you so much for your love. Lord, I pray as the word is spoken that it will just enliven us, empower us more, and that we will walk out of here strong in your presence, excited and ready to take on the week. We just thank you for your presence today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.